What is a narcissist? What they do and why they do it. Hello, today we are going to discuss the narcissist or other controlling types of person in your life. It's very likely that if you have searched out and found this video, that it may already be too late for avoidance advice. However, it's never too late to take control of your life and reclaim your sense of self and to move on with a healthier way of living. First thing to remember and repeat until it becomes a part of your daily consciousness is that you are not to blame. You did nothing wrong by being lured in and trapped into a toxic relationship by someone who has set out to victimize others to benefit themselves. Your happiness or success in life has never been part of their plans. You want and should desire happiness and contentment and are not responsible for the terror and chaos that is likely now in control of your life. That other person, the narcissist, whether they are a spouse, significant other, friend, brother, sister, parent, part of your extended family, or coworker, has only their self-interest in mind, no matter what they have promised, and it's guaranteed to be an outright lie. They do not value you as a person, and any outward display of affection or loyalty is based solely upon their ability to mimic or copy what a normal person does. Most of us discuss the issues with the significant other or spouse dealing with the narcissist because friends or coworkers, although not easy to resolve or escape from, are far easier to cope with than an intimate relationship, especially when there are children involved that are shared between you and the narcissist. Before we begin to define what the traits of a narcissist are, I'd like to throw out some examples of what you are likely experiencing. After the initial love bombing and unusual attention that you received from the narc, you probably noticed that the high and lofty place that you thought you occupied in their mind has quickly been replaced by their disappointment in you. You no longer hold a position of high esteem that you had cherished early in the relationship. Boundaries are often pushed, then stretched, often in small phases at first. They may test your ability to accept their paranoid, self-centered world with simple gaslighting. Psychology Today has a list of questions to ask yourself to determine if you are being gaslighted. Do they try to persuade you to doubt the evidence of your senses and what you are thinking and feeling? Do they try to convince you that what you believe is wrong and what they believe is right? Do they react badly if you do not accept their version of the truth? Are they extremely persistent and sometimes keep the argument going long after you have asked them to please drop the issue? Do they attempt to bully you into admitting that they are 100% right and you are completely wrong? Are the facts always twisted so that they are the victim and you are always at fault? Do they twist and turn the truth and make such long and complicated arguments to prove their points that, after a while, you become thoroughly confused? If you find yourself answering yes to many of the above questions, you may be being gaslighted. At first, you may just write this off as a simple quirk of their personality. Surely this individual who has shown me such affection in the past is just having a bad day. They often use feeling a little ill or I had a bad day at work as an excuse to get off the hook. You go along with it. After their initial probing of what you would accept, it probably didn't take long before the first explosive attack against you took place. You will be accused of something outrageous. You are likely sent reeling because the nature of the accusation is so obviously contrary to your very nature. Maybe it's jealousy. You have been seeing someone behind their back or a projection of abandonment. You might be accused of abandoning them in the future based on a hypothetical incident that has not even taken place. They may ruin your special occasions such as birthdays, promotion, holidays, anniversaries, or any good news by trying to take the attention away from you because they, of course, want to be the center of attention. They will likely claim that you did something to ruin the event by flipping the script on you. If you don't go along with their make-believe reality, they may resort to the silent treatment, hostility, or even violence. If you challenge a narc, you are challenging their reality that they have carefully constructed in order to avoid responsibility and doing the hard work of improving themselves. They do not want to have a good look in the mirror. They will not like what they see. If you are dealing with what is referred to as a garden variety narcissist, life can be uncomfortable and sometimes unpleasant, for a self-obsessed person is only in it for themselves. On the other hand, if you are dealing with a pathological narcissist, they will not stop until they get their way. Narcissists lack empathy. They do not have the capacity to be a contributing part of a healthy relationship. They are selfish and are only concerned with their own feelings. They are egocentric and expect you to think and feel the same way they do and seldom give any thought to how others feel. They are rarely apologetic, remorseful, or guilty. Narcissists feel entitled. They expect and demand special treatment from you. They want you to cater to their needs with no hope of reciprocation from them. This is their world. Others exist only to satisfy their needs and whims. The world revolves around them. Many narcissists enjoy spreading and arousing negative emotion to gain attention, feel powerful, and keep you insecure and off balance. They are easily upset at any real or perceived slights or inattentiveness. They may throw a tantrum if you disagree with their views or fail to meet their expectations. They have to always be right, never to be blamed. They are extremely sensitive to criticism and typically respond with heated argument or cold detachment. On the other hand, narcissists are often quick to judge, criticize, ridicule, and blame you. Some narcissists are emotionally abusive. By making you feel inferior, they boost their fragile ego and feel better about themselves. It is important to understand that the gaslighting or accusations directed at you are not the goal of the narcissist. They use these tactics to get a reaction from you, which they feed off of. They do this to make you be on the defensive and to change the subject. They do this so that you are thrown off balance so they can have the upper hand. The subject, of course, is not the attacks or accusation. It's the narcissist's needs. They have created an imaginary world where they exist at the center of, and it is, of course, impossible for a healthy person to understand what it is that they want. You can never satisfy a narcissist even if you apologize, beg forgiveness, or do everything they want. And what is worse, if you do give in, then you become the object of their contempt. If you knuckle under to the narc's unhealthy wishes, you believe that you can pacify them, and you may do just that. For now, but in the long run, they lose respect for you and the cycle grows deeper and you are locked in a literal death spiral, as the conditions that you will be forced to live under can and will be unhealthy for you. On the other hand, if you are at a point in your life that you come to fear the next day, when you go to sleep at night recoiling at the thought of another day living in what seems like a police state where you no longer are allowed to feel or have your own thoughts. Everything you do and think has to mirror the narcissist, or else. If you have come to a place in your life where you feel this is not normal, that this is not a healthy, loving relationship, and you attempt to challenge the narc, you may be entering dangerous territory here because, from the narcissist's point of view, you are the cause of all the problems and they are always the victim. It can be no other way. You challenge their worldview that has only them at the center. They will try to isolate you, much like members of a cult, to keep you from associating with healthy people, including those closest to you, close friends, family, and especially your parents. Mothers are often at the top of the list to peel away from the victim. It is vital to the narc that you have no viable lifeline. Once you become part of their imaginary paranoid world, they do not want you to escape until, of course, they grow tired of you, if you are lucky, and they discard you for the next victim who will feed them with a fresh supply of attention that the narc so craves. Now for the traits of narcissism I mentioned earlier. Signs and symptoms. In the American Psychiatric Association's Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, or the DSM, fifth edition is defined as comprising a persuasive pattern of grandiosity in fantasy or behavior, a constant need for admiration and lack of empathy, beginning by early adulthood and present in a variety of contexts, as indicated by the presence of at least five of the following nine criteria. A grandiose sense of self-importance, a preoccupation with fantasies of unlimited success, power, brilliance, beauty, or ideal love, a belief that he or she is special and unique and can only be understood by or should associate with other special or high-status people or institutions, a need for excessive admiration, a sense of entitlement, interpersonally exploitive behavior, a lack of empathy, envy of others, or a belief that others are envious of him or her, a demonstration of arrogant and haughty behaviors or attitudes. In a proposed alternative model cited in DSM-5, narcissistic personality disorder is characterized by moderate or greater impairment personality functioning manifested by characteristic difficulties in two or more of the following four areas: identity, self-direction, empathy, intimacy. In addition, narcissistic personality disorder, or NPD, is characterized by the presence of both grandiosity and attention seeking. With the exception of relationships where there are children of yourself and the narcissist are involved, or if you are a grandparent or some other close relative of the narc's children, the best advice is to get out of Dodge, and fast. Sever all relationship or ties with the narcissist. They will feel rejected and will likely make repeated and vigorous attempts at steering you back under their control. The tactics they employ may include, but are not limited to, the appearance of regret or asking for forgiveness, which is not genuine. They only want their property back, you. They need the narcissistic supply that you were at one time so generous with. They will attempt to trick and con you into giving them another chance. If you are fortunate, they will move on to an easier target. Unfortunate for the easier target, of course. While studying martial arts, I was taught that a common criminal or mugger you pass on the streets would prefer to attack and rob an easy target, someone vulnerable who will not put up a fight. In a similar way, the narcissist will avoid seeking out a relationship with people who are not willing to put up with their crap, and like the mugger, they can spot a target a mile away. Always keep this in mind. The narcissist does not like to lose. They want the last word. They will not give up without a fight. If they think you got the upper hand or somehow won in their eyes, then you may be in for a difficult time. I am expressing my opinions based on some experience dealing with controlling personality types. If you are in a toxic relationship and think you can extract yourself on your own, that's amazing. You have to do what works for you, not what I suggest or what may work for others. Please consult a professional or law enforcement if you feel that your or other lives may be threatened or in danger. If there is enough interest in this subject, I will follow up with videos that explore very specific areas of life that deal with narcissistic, controlling, and toxic people. Thank you for watching, and I wish you success and a speedy recovery from an unhealthy or caustic life. You deserve more, much more.